Good morning, everyone. Today we are examining Ezekiel chapter 1. And as we went through and read the chapter yesterday, we talked about a couple of different things in introduction to the chapter. And I want to go back and deal with a couple of other things as we deal with some lessons from the chapter this morning. So the first place that we want to start is in verses 2 and 3. As you get to this introduction of Ezekiel, we recognize, first of all, that Ezekiel is a priest. So he's not just going to be the prophet of God amongst the people there at the River Kibar, but rather he is also going to be one who is a priest. And many of the things that he is going to say, many of the things that God is going to use him in order to relate are going to be related to his office as a priest and his relationship to the people as a priest. And so those are going to be things to watch out for during the book of Ezekiel. He is going to be a young priest as well. Most assert that the dating that is given at the beginning of verse number 1 of it being in the 30th year is actually Ezekiel's age at the time that he gets this first vision from God. And if that is the case, and it does seem to be the case, that if it is the 30th year, he would be considered a young priest who is, for the most part, just out of his period of study, just out of his apprenticeship as a priest. And so he would be relatively new in that situation. But it also is such that he has been in captivity now for about 5 years, as we see from the reference to it being the 5th year of Jehoiakim's captivity. And so there's a number of these things that are going to fall into place as you get this basic concept of Ezekiel. In the first chapter, you have this vision that is going to take place. Now, I'm not going to spend 20 minutes going through and breaking down or trying to break down every little detail of the vision, because that's sometimes where we get in trouble when it comes to passages like Ezekiel chapter 1, but also when it comes to passages like the book of Revelation and things of that nature in the New Testament, is we try to make every little detail stand for something or have some relatable reason for it being in this particular text. In Ezekiel chapter 1, you have a vision that is going to occur. And Ezekiel actually tells you what the vision is designed to be and what it was intended to be. It is not going to be something that is overly complex, though we tend to overanalyze it and turn it into something complex. First of all, I want you to notice when it comes to verse 4, he says, "I looked, and behold, a whirlwind was coming out of the north, a great cloud with raging fire engulfing itself, and brightness was all around it, and radiating out of the midst like the color of amber out of the midst of the fire. Also from within it came the likeness of 4 living creatures." You're going to see this term likeness used on at least 5 to 6 occasions within Ezekiel chapter 1, and I believe it's actually more than that. I didn't take time to count every single instance of it. But the word in the Hebrew language simply means the similarity of, or the that it looks similar to. We're talking about not something that is literally present, but something that looks like this. And that's what most of chapter 1 is going to be, is trying to give you an image in your head of what it was that that Ezekiel was looking at looked like. It's not from the standpoint of it being real or that these things are actual occurrences of something that actually exists, but rather these things are likenesses. Remember, this is a vision. It is not an actual occurrence that is going to take place. And so first and foremost, as you examine chapter 1, recognize it is a picture that is being painted, not a narrative of an account of something that took place or of something that was a physical interaction. This is a vision. This is a dream. This is something that is going to take place in the mind of Ezekiel, as far as that goes. But I want you to notice also, as you examine chapter 1, that you have these four creatures, and they're going to be the ones who are going to be the introduction of the king, as far as that goes. And then you're going to move on to the wheels and the rims that are full of eyes that see everything. And then you move in a little bit closer to the throne and to the things that are going to take place there on the throne and the being that is there at the throne. And you get down to the end of Ezekiel chapter 1. And in verse 28 it says, like the appearance of a rainbow in a cloud on a rainy day, so was the appearance of the brightness all around it. And here's the key. Here's the key of everything that is being said in chapter 1. This was the appearance of the likeness of the glory of the Lord. Everything that is being discussed here in chapter 1 is to give a powerful likeness, a powerful similarity, a powerful picture of the glory of God. Of the glory of who God is, of the power of who God is. As you get into chapters 2 and 3, chapters 2 and 3 are going to be a continuation of this event. It's not jumping to a new scene or to something else, but rather the Lord is then going to speak to Ezekiel. But this is the introduction so that Ezekiel knows that the one who he's talking to, or the one who is speaking to him, is actually the Lord. It is not just some figment of his imagination. You're going to see these types of things occur on a number of occasions throughout Scripture. But here you have a specific instance where we have this picture that's being painted of this awesome scene that is laid before us. And the entire point of the entire scene is not for every little concept to be something relatable or to have a purpose or a meaning behind it, but rather to relate the awe and the wonder and the glory of the likeness of the Lord. That's it. That's the key. And so as you examine chapter 1, don't get so focused on making each of the faces of each of the beings mean something, or each of the elements that are described have to have a certain meaning to them. That's not the point. The point is Ezekiel received a vision with a picture of the glory and the presence of the Lord. That's the key. As long as you've got that, everything else is filler material. That's the picture that he wants you to get. So as you look at chapter 1, the major lesson that we want to take away and the major thing that you want to be sure you get is God was coming to see Ezekiel. And he wanted to make sure Ezekiel knew exactly who it was. And tomorrow, as we examine chapters 2 and 3, we will examine the message that is going to correspond to what it is that this vision was meant to introduce and why God used it. So I hope these things have been beneficial to you. I hope that they have helped you when it comes to your understanding of chapter 1. And as I said, Lord willing, tomorrow we will come back and examine chapter 2. And we'll probably do chapters 2 and 3 together. But until then, have a great day.